before I put the headphones on. So like, wait, what?
Sorry, I was doing some weird high-pitched creepy sound. What's up, everybody? It's Joel with another Mix It Up Reactions. I'm here with my co-host,
Hey Jones.
And we're here to do another, we did three songs of Nightmare, Avenged Sevenfold album. And then we did 2 days ago, we did MIA from Avenged Sevenfold from a different album because we were told to mix it up a little bit. We said, okay, let's mix it up a little bit.
It's called Mix It Up. So, you know,
mix it up. Yeah, I know, right? It just dawned on me. Thank you very much for doing that. Okay, so we're going to be checking out Avenged Sevenfold, The Stage.
Okay.
I think it's a music video. I'm not sure. It looks like there's puppets. Like it. Is that puppets?
Possibly.
I don't know. We'll have to figure it out. Anyways, again, this is a first time reaction for both of us because I've not heard anything from The Stage whatsoever. Like the last song I heard of Avenged Sevenfold that I paid attention to was All Hail to the King. And I didn't have a good experience with it. I think it was just the time because I was so obsessed with, you know, like a lot of different styles of music. I used to love Metallica and it sounded too much like it. And I just haven't jammed Metallica in a very long time. So it kind of, it was a bad moment in time.
That's all I have to say. And we'll listen to some of that album, I promise. Okay. Super.
So right now we're going to do Avenged Sevenfold, The Stage. So let's check it out. Forget to like and subscribe. Hit the bell notification to make sure you know when new videos are coming out. Definitely check out the merch. And that was a horrible gesture, but I don't care. So we're going to be checking out The Stage. And yeah, nothing you can do about it. Oh, that's going to be loud. At least I think.
I think my headphones are still kind of loud overall. There we go.
Do I sound loud?
No. No. It was just overall, but you got it.
Cool. Trippy. Spacey.
Jump scare.
So it's like a puppet show. This is really weird.
They're all looking confused, even though they just paid to go inside. Steady.
Whoever the new drummer is. Good. Sounds like he's doing triplets underneath.
Jesus Christ was born to die. Leave it to man to levitate.
language and stuff. It's kind of super honest and slightly violent.
Yes!
Okay. So, did not realize that putting MIA and this song right next to each other, that they would practically blend right into the same story.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, good night. That was like perfect, just happenstance type thing. Because we were going to do like a Rock Am Ring live song today, but we decided to do the stage music video or marionette puppet show or whatever. But literally, we just did MIA. So it's just, that's just pure coincidence.
Yeah.
That's insanity. Okay. One, both of those songs are on, there's two albums in between each of those songs, but they're very similar in
not, the idea.
And the idea, but not just the, this is more of a visual and it's not just one individual person. It's showing more the history of
the fantastical history
of
the world,
the history of how we just war just is a part of us.
Yeah.
And we destroy a lot of good for sometimes the most egotistical things that pointless politicians point us in the direction to do, you know? Yeah, that's totally happenstance that we chose both of those because we're recording these literally back to back, but then they're going to release like 2 days apart. And I'm like, okay, we just so happened to pick two songs that are dangerously like they should go together in the same, like even the arrangement was similar in a lot of ways, you know, not really, but love the classical guitar at the end. That just made it very poignant, very poignant at the end. You kind of, I know why he did it. The hook, the reason he sang it that way, it wasn't the atypical of what he's done in his evolution so far. It was something different. He changed key. And I think the reason, because it gives you this feeling of, you know, what's comfortable, where it's going to go, what sounds great, but you go to something that sounds just as great, but is so different in a choice that it does make you a little uncomfortable. So the message of the story of the history of everything kind of, cause it keeps you moving on the stage. You know, it's like you could easily hit a major note. He went sharp at, or no, he went minor at one point in time. And, you know, did something a little bit different. But it kind of gives your mind this thing where it's like, oh, you go to the safe part that lets me feel that dopamine level, or you go to this part and it's like, oh, well, that's good too. Like you
was that around the time where, like after everyone died and the flowers started blooming?
No, it's what the chorus has been doing the whole time, but it keeps you moving to the next verse. It never lets you get comfortable and safe like they do with other songs where it's like, here's the heavy part, here's the fun part, here's the aggressive part. And then it's relax and prettiness and beautifulness and poppiness. And then back to the heavy stuff. You know, that's usually like the roundabout arrangement. Not exactly. But this kind of, it's like the chorus it stretches those words more. Like he's stretching it more because he wants it just to be slightly uncomfortable, that when you hit in the next verse, you're not completely changed emotional value. You're still in that same feeling of, by the end of this song, you will feel more uncomfortable about the message that they're saying.
Yeah.
Which is honestly a genius way to write that. I think, because it just, it leaves you wondering, or it doesn't leave you wondering. It leaves you going, yeah, that shit is true.
Yeah.
When you think about it.
Well, I was, as we were watching the video, it was probably like 6 minutes in. That's why I stopped and I kind of did this, because I was like, I'm watching the video so closely that I'm not really listening to the lyrics.
Yeah.
And I'm just,
I was doing the same thing.
Just kind of looking like, wow, okay, when you go through all these different eras, you know, and just like, okay, yep.
Yeah,
and then the next, and then the next.
It's easy to say that, like, people talk shit and they're like, you know, Americans are just such bloodthirsty, blah, blah. But the first half of that was definitely not just Americans, you know?
Yeah.
So it's like, oh my God, yeah, that did happen. Oh my God, yeah, I learned about that in school. Oh my goodness.
And that's all the stuff you learned about.
Yeah, yeah, that's all the stuff you learned about. The victors tell the stories, so... there are cultures who've been wiped off the face of the earth that we don't even know existed.
There's this scene in Trolls, the movie Trolls.
I know what you're about to say, but go
ahead. Yeah, but that one, you know, where he says the history book or scrapbook is written by the winners.
Yeah.
And I remember just watching that movie with my kids, and I was like, ooh,
that's deep. That's real honest.
This is a kid's movie, but it's like, yeah, because they killed everybody else, so you don't really know what happened. You don't have
a difference of opinion. Because
they're all fucking dead. Oh,
shouldn't laugh at that, but yeah, no, that's the rub, man. Like, you can sit here and say that, oh, that was a just, like, it's almost like that's what a lot of people ended up talking about. Oh, that was a justified battle. Like, mm-hmm. Come on, man. Really? I mean, maybe. Like, the only one that people can agree on is Hitler. Like, that's the only one that absolutely everyone can agree on.
Yeah.
He had to go.
Yeah.
He could not stay. It's interesting when you look at our history. It's like, yeah, there's a lot of killing and mayhem and death over dumb stuff.
Well, I thought it was interesting that the crowd in the beginning, they're just like, okay, what is this? What are we doing here? And then as it goes, some they're of like, them are laughing. Yeah. And I mean, I remember reading about that stuff in the books where they like beheaded folks and there's a crowd. It's like, wait, people gathered to watch life be taken. Like, I couldn't imagine that.
I don't understand it, but we don't live in that world. Yeah, think about it. We don't live in that world.
Oh, no, I know.
I mean, think about this. How many people smelled and what they smelled like?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Just no soap.
Hygiene. Yeah.
I mean, you want to know why the plague was able to run rampant? Because half the people hadn't washed an armpit in 20 years. Oh, the smell.
I mean, and you especially think about when the you smell make, and you make babies. Yeah.
Think about London in the late 1800s, how horrible that place smelled, where everyone's compacted in and they're pouring their shit in the streets and stuff. Yeah. Come on now, dude, that's gross.
And they straight all up. Had like 5+ kids.
Oh yeah. Well, you had to have a big lot back then because half of them were going to be dead within a couple years.
No, I get that, but
you had to hedge your bets. I mean, don't get me wrong. We're not history buffs. We don't know exactly what everything is. It's just what we've seen in documentaries and TV shows.
From the winners.
And from the winners.
Yeah, what we've learned from the winners. Yeah.
Okay. I like the song because the message is very powerful. Like that and MIA go perfect together in story and song. Like that's awesome.
I know. Now I think you have to pick what's going to play for Friday so it makes sense.
No, MIA is going to play first.
Yeah.
And no, that's going to play on Monday.
One. Yeah. So this would be the Wednesday. This would be
Wednesday. Yeah.
You know, throw people off on Friday.
Anyway. Yeah, right.
What are we doing Friday? Is there another song that matches that one?
No. Don't forget, you know, in all honesty, this is the longest we've had because I kind of forgot we were actually having a podcast at this time.
Oh, it's fine. It's a long video. It's okay.
Yeah. So don't forget to like and subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell notification. Know when new videos come out. Make sure you also check out our merch. And be sure to take a look for when trial and error stuff comes out. You know, eventually it will. Who knows? Whatever. Eventually. I don't care. But yeah, this was good 2 song picks. We got lucky because I would have picked something else that probably would have annoyed people. So this helped. Yeah.
I need a brain reset.
We're going to do another nightmare song next.
Okay.
So that'll be Friday. It'll be another nightmare song. All right. Then we'll do another nightmare song on Monday. And then we'll do 2 other ones like a Rock Am Ring, God Hates Us or something like that. Okay. Rock Am Ring. I think it's Rock Am Ring. Rock Am Ring. 2011. That show.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. There's another one that somebody told me it was from a Japanese show. So we need to, he said that one was really good. So he's going to put it on his channel and I'm going to grab the link and we're going to do that one.
Okay.
So stupendous. Anyways, we'll talk to you guys later.